In this video, I will show how to authenticate a React frontend with a Spring Boot Spring Security backend with the JWT and the roles. I've already done a video about authenticating a React frontend with a Spring Boot backend with the JWT. Today, I will only modify the previous application to implement the roles. Okay, with the JWT, I'm able to access the backend, but I can't allow a single user access all the data in my Spring Boot application. I have a website which sells farts from celebrities. I will have users who can buy farts, other users who can sell farts, and other users who can administrate the site. To split this behavior, I have two things to do. In the backend, I must protect the buyer's endpoint to be only accessible by the buyers. Same for the sellers and same for the admins. But the frontend also needs to know to whom the JWT belongs to display an adequate interface. So, I will store inside the JWT the roles information. Then, the frontend must be able to decrypt the JWT and read the roles information. This way, the frontend can display a different interface depending on the role. As said, I've already done a video about creating the JWT and configuring Spring Security. Today, I will only apply the roles configuration. But first, click on the subscribe button. The roles are restricted in the controller with the following annotations. I go to my controller, controllers, fart controller, and here I add the annotations. PreAuthorize has authority, user, celebrity, and admin. But to use those annotations, I need to add a configuration of Spring Security. So I go to the Spring Security configuration and add another annotation, enable method security. With this annotation, I have now access to a lot of method level annotations. With the annotation enable method security, I can use the following annotations in my endpoint or anywhere else. Inside those annotations, I can use an SPeL expression, a Spring expression language. This gives me access to plenty of methods like this. This one permits all the requests under any circumstances, and this one denies all the requests. Those check the authorities present in the user authentication bin. Those are the same, but the authorities must be prefixed by role. And this one is for more fine-grained authorities when using the permissions. The permissions are a level under the roles, and I may want to protect my endpoints by permissions instead of roles. So let's create a new field in the user's entity with the roles and add the roles in the user authentication bin. I start creating the enum with all the roles. I create a new package, enums, and I create an enum role with the roles admin, celebrity, and user. Let's now add the attribute of the role to the user object. I go to the entities, here is my user, and I add a new field. Private role role. I specify it's a column, nullable false, and indicate it's an enum, enumerated value. Enum type string. This way, in the database, I only store the name of the row, the name of the enum, not the integer value. Let's go to the DTO to also add this field. DTOs, user. And I add the role at the last position. When creating a user, I want it to be, by default, a user. So, I go to the service, and in the register method, when the user is created, I add user. Set role, role user. I have a new field role in the user's object. I have my endpoints protected by a method. I need now to add the role in the authentication bin when validating the request. Let's go to the config package and open the user authentication provider. In the validate token, I create the user password authentication token bin, but here I set empty to the authorizations. Now it's time to use the roles. I create an array list with the user role, get row. But the values in this input parameter must implement granted authority. So let's go to the enum to implement granted authority. Implement granted authority. And it returns the name of the enum, which will be admin, celebrity, or user. My backend is ready now. But as said at the beginning, I want my frontend to be aware when the user is an admin, a celebrity, or a regular user. So I need to store the role inside the JWT. Back to the user authentication provider, now I go to the create token method. Here, when creating the token, I add a new claim with the name role and the value user get role name. And now let's go to the frontend to read the role information inside the JWT. To decrypt the JWT, I need a library. npm install JWT decode. Now I will create an object which reflects the custom fields of my JWT with my custom claim. Go to the source folder and create a directory entity with a new file, custom JWT payload.tsx. Export interface custom JWT payload, which extends the JWT payload. The JWT payload is the default object returned when I decode a JWT. And here I add a new field, role, which is a string. And now I add the import of JWT payload. Import JWT payload from JWT decode. Now, when rendering the main component, I load the adequate message depending on the role. I go to the app component. And here I only have two components, the login when I'm not authenticated and the farts when I'm authenticated. Let's now modify this. I start by importing the JWT decode dependency. Import JWT decode from JWT decode. And in the user effect, when it's authenticated, I try to decode the JWT. JWT decode into my new created interface, custom JWT payload, the token decoded. Let's import this. Import custom JWT payload from entity. Custom JWT payload. I create a new variable, const role set role, use state user by default, and once decoded, I set the role decoded role. And when rendering, I display the login if I'm not authenticated. If I'm authenticated and the role is user, I display farts. If it's admin,
if it's
celebrity, I display admin farts or celebrity farts. Let's add the imports. And let's test all together. Here is the login page when I have no authenticated user. I try first with an admin user. Admin, admin. And here is the admin interface. If I go to the console, remove the JWT from the local storage. This way I simulate a logout. I refresh the page. And now I will log in with a regular user. Sergio, Sergio. And now here is the user's interface. Let's make a quick recap. I've added the enable method security annotation. I've added the annotation pre-authorize to protect my endpoints. When creating the authentication bin, I've added the authority from the role of my user. The role enum must implement the granted authority interface. I've also added a custom claim in my JWT. On the frontend, I've added a new dependency, JWT decode. Once the user logged, I decode the JWT to read the role value and display the adequate interface. That's all for this video. I hope you liked it. Don't forget to click on the like button, subscribe to my channel, and see you soon. Bye!